This customer has had the water board out and they've identified a hidden water leak. A full rotation of the red dial indicates a litre. There's nowhere near the previous video at 1,000 litres an hour. The internal stopcock is in the garage. We shut that off and the meter stops. So we'll turn the water back on in the garage after. Let's get it. Started in the loft. The tank was slightly dripping, as you can see. But with the feed isolated, the meter was still active. So the leak's somewhere else. The check is definitely isolated. Good stuff. Looking around, the main feed goes up into the ceiling. And I was shown this feed, which goes up into the newish ensuite above, apparently. And it's connected under the utility room floor. It looks a bit damp there as well. So there's an outside tap feed from the garage. Here's a spanner in the works. At the bottom of the garden, there was a water feed to a sink and three taps. And no one knows where the pipes run or connected in the house. So once the stopcock in the garage is isolated, this area has no water. So it could be in the mix to be leaking. There's the blue mains coming out the ground. Set the gases up. So the pipe feeding down here could be anywhere. There's no sign of it connected in the house, but it has to be. I would have thought it'd be run under or either side of these steps. And also, according to the customer, they have had this patio up a few times because it's been sinking in places. And they found a cooker and some radiators just buried. As soon as they said that, I got a bit worried. What else could be down there? My suspicion is the pipe work is either connected from the kitchen or the utility room, just here, under the floor in the property. As you can imagine, it took a long time to get any evidence anywhere, but everything was pointing towards this area in the utility room under the unit. It's hard to hear, but the leak can be heard. There's a plastic membrane, so all the evidence could be travelling. So I removed this unit, which went surprisingly well. Everything come out in one piece, so it can go back in one piece, which is good. So started to access the leak. Originally, I thought that pipe had the leak, but reaching down there, I could feel a blue mains pipe. Pulling on it made the leak worse. And I found that the leak was travelling. And there we go. After moving some bits around the garage and exposing the leak, the mystery of the pipe feeding the garden sink has been found to be leaking. And as you can see, it's converting from copper. So I managed to repair the leak. We turned the water on slowly to test it. And there was a brick up against the blue pipe here, which I removed to remove the stress in the fitting. It's looking good. So I protected the pipe work and filled with sand and concreted over at the end of the job. Started removing the rubble and cleaning up. The unit managed to go back perfectly, which I'm very happy about. It's like I wasn't even there. And this area was concreted as well, agreed with the customer. So put that back with a slap. Oh, before I forget, open back up the tank feed in the loft. There's nothing worse than driving 2 hours home and getting a call saying, I have no water. It's easily done. There we go, another happy customer. Job's a good one. If you have a leak, let's get it.